I'm Katie from OptiSign's product team. Today I'll show you how to create and use your own playlist. First, you'll need to make sure that you have uploaded all your files and created your assets. Then, navigate to the playlist section of our portal. Here, you can see that we have three parts. On the left side, all of your playlists will be listed here in this section. You can also create a new one by clicking on the Create Playlist button. You can also change your playlist name by simply clicking on the pencil icon and changing it. If someone has shared a playlist or folder with you, it will appear when you click on this icon. You can also create a folder to organize your playlist by clicking on the folder plus icon and giving it a name, and then clicking Save. You can move your playlist inside this folder by selecting the playlist and clicking Move to choose the folder and moving it over. The search bar at the top will help you find your playlists and folders by name faster. You can also adjust and filter how your playlist will appear in this section, either by creation, updates, or name when you're searching. On the right side, you'll see all your assets and folders from your file and asset library. You can also create new assets here by clicking the new option. To get your playlist started, you just need to drag and drop the assets into the middle section. You can also arrange the order of them and set the duration for each one. By default, each item is set to 10 seconds, except for videos, which will match their length. To change the duration, you just need to click on the pencil icon and adjust the duration to what you'd like it to be. So, if you want all your items to have the same duration, you can click Selected and click Edit Duration and enter the time. It's super fast and easy. If you adjust a video duration, you can always easily revert it to its original length by clicking on the Reset Duration to default and clicking Save. Now, let's move to the playlist setting bar. So here we'll have the undo and redo option for you to fix any mistakes or redo any actions. Next is the push to screen option. First, you'll need to choose the screen that you want to assign this playlist to. If you want this playlist to display immediately on the screen, you can simply choose the push option. And if you don't want this playlist to display immediately and you want it to schedule it for a future time, you can choose the schedule changes option, setting it for when you want it to go live and when you'd like it to expire. Afterwards, it'll revert back to the original content assigned to the screen or stop playing entirely. If you want to briefly display this playlist, you can choose the temporary takeover, which is the playlist will temporarily take over the screen for a specific period of time. And then when that time reaches its end, it will revert back to the previous content. The preview option will help you preview your playlist before displaying it. Next, add playlist is if you'd like a nested playlist within your playlist. You can either select the playlist through this drop-down menu, or you can drag and drop a playlist from the left section into the middle section. The cog icon will open your playlist options. You can adjust the scaling of images, videos, and documents to better fit the contents to your screen. The shuffle option will randomize the order of assets in your playlist when pushed to screens. You can also choose from a variety of transitions and change the transition speed for when content within your playlist changes. In the advanced options, you can adjust the maximum duration for your playlist playback in seconds. Background music will allow you to add music, either an MP3 file or URL, to play alongside your playlist. The option Advanced Playback Settings Apply To lets you apply restrictions on the playlist items so that the item will only play or not play on certain screens. The Target Tags option is a grouping method for screens that you will need to use if you set a content tag rule for your screens. Please see our video and support article for more information on this feature. Item Schedule lets you control the schedule of each playlist item. Sub-playlist Control allows you to define how many items you want to play from a sub-playlist and the maximum duration per item in seconds. When Resume on Next Play is enabled, the playlist will resume from where it left off last time, rather than starting from the beginning. And then Respect Orientation lets you choose the orientation you would like for your playlist. The three dots will let you move or duplicate the playlist. Produce a share link so you can share this playlist with others. A playlist operation report is a summary of the features activated within your playlist. Where used will show you if your playlist is being currently used on a screen, schedule, or split screen. And you can also delete your playlist. And last but not least, you'll need to assign this playlist to your screen. And that's how you create and use your own playlist on OptiSigns. If you have any questions or feedback about this feature, you can always reach out to our support team at support@optisigns.com or hit the green button at the bottom right of our portal. Thanks for watching!